पार्टिकल इन वन डायमेंशनल बॉक्स. हेलो लर्नर्स, वी लर्न दैट द माइक्रोस्कोपिक पार्टिकल लाइक इलेक्ट्रॉन इन एन एटम मूविंग अराउंड द न्यूक्लियस एज ए वेव कॉल्ड मैटर वेव. व्हाट हैपन व्हेन सच माइक्रोस्कोपिक पार्टिकल्स लाइक इलेक्ट्रॉन इज अलाउड टू मूव इन ए लिमिटेड स्पेस. इन दिस लेक्चर वी आर गोइंग टू ऑब्जर्व द बिहेवियर ऑफ such microscopic particle like electron when trapped in a limited space called one dimensional box. Let us consider particle in a one dimensional box of length L. The electron is moving along the x direction within the box only. This is the one dimensional box of length L having infinitely high wall at two ends. One wall at x is equal to 0 and second wall at x is equal to L. The potential energy inside the box is 0 while outside the box is found infinity. As potential energy outside the box is infinity, this electron is only allowed to move in x direction and allowed to come back. Within this one-dimensional box only, that means the particle is only found inside the box. Let us derive Schrödinger equation first. Let us start with eigenvalue equation h cap psi, which is equal to e psi. This is equation number one. This h cap is the Hamiltonian operator. Hamiltonian operator. Psi is wave function. And E is the energy. We have equation for Hamiltonian operator, which is minus 8 square upon 8 pi square m multiplied by dabba square upon dabba x square plus V. In equation number 2, h cap is the Hamiltonian operator. We know that h is the Planck constant, m is mass of electron, x is the displacement of electron along the x-axis, v is the potential energy. Now we are going to put this value of h cap into the equation 1 in this place. Then equation 1 becomes as minus 8 square 8 pi square m dabba square upon dabba x square psi multiply with this, therefore here psi plus v psi, which is equal to e psi. This is equation number third. Now we are transfer this e psi to the left hand side. Then equation 3 becomes as minus 8 square upon 8 pi square m dabba square psi upon dabba x square plus v psi minus e psi, which is equal to 0. This is equation number 4. If you make some rearrangement in equation number 4 and we change the sign, then equation 4 we can write as minus, it is plus, h square upon 8 pi square m dabba square psi upon dabba x square plus e minus v psi, which is equal to 0. This is equation number 5. If you multiply equation 5 with the term 8 pi square m upon h square, then equation 5 becomes as dabba square psi upon dabba x square plus 8 pi square m upon h square e minus v psi, which is equal to 0. This is equation number 6. And as we already derived, this is the Schrödinger wave equation with respect to x direction only. This equation 7 is the Schrödinger wave equation of a particle moving along the single direction, that is the x direction. Here in this equation, potential energy V is assumed as a continuous, but if you observe the box, then here the potential energy is not continuous or not single. Here where x is equal to 0 and x is equal to L, at this potential energy is suddenly rises. Here potential energy is 0, but here the potential energy suddenly rises. Therefore it is convenient to consider the Schrodinger equation inside and outside the box separately. So we are going to consider this Schrodinger equation first outside the box and then inside the box. Let us see the Schrodinger equation. Outside the box, where the potential energy is infinity, then the equation 7 becomes as d squares dabba square psi upon dabba x square plus 8 pi square m upon h square multiplied by e minus the potential energy outside the box is infinity psi, which is equal to 0. This is equation number 8. Now in next step we are going to multiply this equation 8 by h square upon 8 pi square m, then we will get h square upon 8 pi square m dabba square psi upon dabba x square plus e minus infinity psi, which is equal to 0. This is equation number 9. So by multiplying with first term we will get this term. If you multiply this with this, then this term get cancelled. What remains? E minus infinity psi, which is equal to 0. Okay, now we are going to multiply this psi to this bracket, then we will get h square upon 8 pi square m dabba square psi upon dabba x square plus e psi minus infinity psi. This equation is 10. Now we are going to transfer this term to the right hand side, then we will get h square upon 8 pi square m dabba square psi upon dabba x square minus infinity psi, which is equal to minus e psi. This is equation number 11. Then we are going to change the sign of equation 11. Then we will get minus h square upon 8 pi square m dabba square psi upon dabba x square plus infinity psi, which is equal to plus e psi. So equation 12 is the result of change in sign of whole equation 11. So this is the equation. Here the potential energy is infinity. So potential energy is infinite. So beyond the boundaries of the box the potential energy is infinite. So particle has no chance of being found in this region. So beyond this region, so already the at the wall of this box the potential energy is very high. Because of that, this particle that found in within the box is not possible to transfer this potential energy of this wall, because it has less potential energy than this wall of the box. So there is no chance of being found this particle outside this box. Now the Schrodinger wave equation inside the box where potential energy is 0. The Schrodinger equation 7 becomes as dabba square psi upon dabba x square plus 8 pi square m upon h square e minus the value of v inside the box is 0 psi, which is equal to 0. This is equation number 13. Now, dabba square psi upon dabba x square plus 8 pi square m upon h square e psi, which is equal to 0. This is equation number 14. This equation becomes as minus h square 8 pi square m dabba square psi upon dabba x square, which is equal to e psi. This is equation number 15. Due to infinitely large potential energy beyond these boundaries of the box, the particle has no chance of being found in this region, that is outside the box, where x is greater than 0 or x is less than L. So since psi that must be 0 at x is equal to 0 and x is equal to L, this boundary condition, so this is the boundary condition that we set for this particle in a box system. So the Schrodinger wave equation inside the box is d square psi upon dx square plus k square psi, which is equal to 0. So this is equation 16, where k square is equal to 8 pi square m upon h square e. This is equation number 17. So here this term in place of this term we can write k square. So equation 17. Now here if you rearrange this equation for e, e is equal to k square h square upon 8 pi square m. So this is the 18th equation, is the equation for the energy of particle that present inside the box. The equation 16 that satisfy the function like sine of kx, cos of kx, that is for all these functions are finite, single valued and continuous. That fulfilling the criteria of an acceptable wave function. The criteria of acceptable wave function. So the general solution to equation 16 is psi, which is equal to a sine of kx plus b cos of kx. This is equation 19, where a and b are the arbitrary constants. The value of a, b and k are determined by setting or putting the boundary conditions as follow. Now we are going to calculate value of arbitrary constant a, b and the constant k by putting the boundary condition. First boundary condition is at x is equal to 0, psi is equal to 0. The equation number 19, that is psi is equal to a sine of kx plus b cos of kx. This is equation number 19. In this equation we are going to put psi is equal to 0, a sine kx is 0 plus b cos kx is 0. Here we know that sine of 0 is 0, cos of 0 is 1. So we are going to put these values into equation number or above equation, then we will get 0 is equal to sine of 0 is 0 multiplied by a 0, so it becomes 0. Cos of 0 1, 1 multiplied by k, it becomes b. So here we will get the value of b is equal to 0. Now we are going to put this value of b into equation number 19. Here b is equal to 0, and if b is equal to 0, that multiplied by cos, it becomes 0. So whole term, that becomes 0. So only psi is equal to a sine of kx, this equation only remains. The second boundary condition, b x is equal to l psi is equal to 0. This boundary condition we are going to put into equation this, then we will get psi is equal to 0, a sine of k, and value of l, x is l. This is equation number 22. In order to satisfy this equation, either you have to use value of a is equal to 0 or k l is equal to n pi. So if you put the value of a is equal to 0 into equation number 21, then we will get psi is equal to 0. But particle inside the box, that electron that moving along the x axis, that are present inside the box, where psi is not equal to 0. Why? Because if you square it, then it becomes 0, and square of psi is nothing but probability. Finding electron inside one dimensional box, so it becomes 0 and it is not possible. Why? Because if we put a is equal to 0 into this equation, then we will get psi is equal to 0, and if you square it, it becomes 0. That means the probability of finding this electron inside the box is 0, and it is not possible. Because if it is possible, then we can conclude that the electron is not present inside the box. But at the start of this lecture, we assume that the electron is present inside the box. So this is not applicable. So this value is acceptable. So we'll write KL is equal to n pi. And if you rearrange for K, then this L transfer to this side, n pi divided by L. So this is the value of k. Then in next step, let's say it is 23, we are going to put the value of k into equation number 21, then it equation becomes as psi is equal to a sine of, in place of k we write n pi upon l and multiply by x as it is. Let's say this is equation number 24. This equation number 24 is the wave function of particle or electron that moving in a one dimensional box along the x direction. So this is the wave function of electron that present in one dimensional box. A is the constant, n is the principal quantum number. N is principal quantum number having value 1, 2, 3 and so on. So n is not 0, but that are having other than 0 value. This is called as a principal quantum number. L is the length of this box. Length of this box. X is the displacement of this electron along the x direction. So this is the wave function. It is very important. This is the wave function of the electron. Now we are going to calculate the energy of electron inside the box. For that purpose, we use a equation k square is equal to e is equal to k square h square upon 8 pi square m. This is 18th equation. E is equal to k square h square upon 8 pi square m. We have the value of k. K is the n pi upon l. If you square it, then it is n square pi square upon l square. We are going to put this value into this equation. Then E is equal to n square pi square upon l square. This is the value of k square. Remaining portion multiplied by h square upon 8 pi square m. This pi square, this pi square get cancelled. This is the E is equal to n square h square upon 8 m l square. This is equation 19. And this is the energy of moving electron inside the box. So this energy of moving inside the box is depend upon the principal quantum number n value. Because h is constant, m is constant, l is constant. Therefore, the energy of the moving electron inside the box is depend upon the principal quantum number n. Here n is having value 1, 2, 3, 4 and so on. If this is the energy of electron moving inside the box, it depends upon the principal quantum number. Therefore, the energy inside the box is quantized. Quantized in the sense, if this is the one-dimensional box, the energies of this depend upon n. That means this is the first energy for n is equal to 1. This is the second energy for n is equal to 2. This is the third energy level for n is equal to 3. So this is E1, it is E2 and it is E3. This is called as a quantization of energy. Whatever energy levels that present inside the box that are quantized. That means that depends upon their or that are present just like the steps. Now, if you put value n is equal to 1, that means lowest possible value of n into equation number 19, then we will get E n is equal to 1, which is equal to 1 square, that becomes 1, that means h square upon 8 m l square. This is equation number 20. So this is the energy what we are getting for value of n is equal to 1, and n is equal to 1 is the lowest principal quantum number. Therefore, the energy for lowest principal quantum number is called as a zero point energy. The lowest energy of particle inside the box is E is equal to h square 8 m l square. It is not zero. It is not zero. That means it is other than zero. Therefore, we say that the particle inside the box is not at the rest. They are not at the rest. That means if this is the nucleus of atom and these are the energy levels. These are the energy levels. So electron present in first energy level, not in the nucleus. If electron present in the nucleus, if this is the case, then zero point energy is zero. But in this case, it is not zero. Therefore, electron is not present inside the nucleus, but it present in first energy level where n is equal to 1 or n is equal to 2, n is equal to 3. So electron is present in any one of this energy level but not in the nucleus. Why? Because the lowest possible energy is not zero. If it is zero, then that present inside the nucleus, but it is not zero. Therefore, they are present in the any energy level of any energy level that depend upon value of n. So this is about the particle in a one dimensional box. So here we calculate the wave function of the particle inside the box, the energy of that particle inside the box, the lowest possible energy of that particle inside the box. Thank you. Thank you very much.